What is a gangster?
Okay, so for me, my experience is it's not the gangsters with all the gold and all that and stuff like that. For me, it's a person that is connected to an organisation that can pull strings, that has the money to do it and the connections to do it. Some of them have connections, top connections, whether it be police connections, whether it be customs office connections, whatever they've got. And it's a person that is able to do what they say they can do when they can say they can do it.
Mr. Terry Ellis. Terry is known for the real-life Ocean's 11 robbery, and he's also now an author and a novelist of four books. How are we doing today? You all right?
Yeah, not too bad, mate. I'm a bit nervous. You know, I was finding a little bit nervous doing these podcasts. I'd rather fucking rob a bank than do a podcast.
So, because when you see someone with a balaclava on and a gun held at you, you don't know what's going on.
2007, I was approached by a really good friend of mine. He fixes high-end jobs. So he phoned me up. Asked me if I could meet him over Hampstead Heath. He was working for a banking consortium of guys that wanted some data retrieved from a data facility in London.
You get lost and blinded by that sort of environment. You know, it's easy to get sucked in into that lifestyle because it's not respecting it, it's respecting what you can get them.
Yeah, of course.
And when you end up in prison, that respect has gone from them people.
One of those jobs that most people would never take on, simply because it's got one of the most state-of-the-art security systems. It's got everything.
They raided my mum's house, and that's when another thing, when she said, you know what, that's enough's enough. You know, you got to get some help. You got to get yourself sorted. You got to get away from this.
There's always one person who's going to let the whole security system down, and that's the human element of it.
Right.
So we thought, we'll have a look at it and see what we can do. But when I realised it was Verizon, and when I told my guys, they all said no.
So when I first went inside, I was very nervous. When you get into the van, because I went, I was arrested, went to court, straight from court, you go straight into the van, just stuck in a box. Like, you're stuck there, the box is there, you're looking out the window, you've got your things there. And I was just thinking, what am I doing with my life? Like, what's going on?
Well, we was quite lucky because my mate had lots of information on it. So we had all the schematics, so we knew the alarm system, we knew basically a hell of a lot about it. But it was just about going down and having a look at it.
And I put the belly on. You get this nervous sense of vulnerability yourself, and then you go in there and you change this persona who you are.
Yeah.
And you're just in there, it's all militant, you don't care, and you do it. And then I came back out and sat in the car, and there was a sense of remorse. But these people didn't have remorse. They were, you know, it's what they do.
Cameras, so you've got standard cameras and thermal, so the clarity is clear day or night. You've got a perimeter fence all the way around the back of this and it backs onto a canal. Three police stations within a mile distance. And it's got, I think this place, in the daytime there's five security guards because it's open. And at night time there's 10 security guards.
The guys come in, drove down. One guy I'd never seen before got in the back of the car. And one guy got in the front, the one that I know, and he's like, where's the gear? I said, where's the money? Or where's the gear? Mm-hmm. So he slid around from there with the knife. So we want the gear. I said, I can't give you the gear unless you get the money. And then he sliced me. Doctor came in and he said, what happened? And I said, I tripped at a barbecue and went through the window. He said, tell me what happened. I said, that's what happened.
It's got bulletproof glass. It's an intercom, biometric, keypad hand scanner and everything else to get
in. So you can't even walk in there?
You can't even walk in there. Once you're through that door, you come into an airlock compartment. So what happens, you get buzzed in, you then have to go through an airlock compartment. That's thermostatically pressurised. So you have to shut this door, and once it's pressurised, you open that door, or it's a human trap.
Yeah.
If you get caught in that, you're fucked.
I had to do things that I wasn't proud of, and I had to be someone that I wasn't. I had to be that person at the time, but now, you know, when I step back and look at that, I think, you know, it's mad. And he kept saying it. He said, I'll come and kill him, I'll get on the plane, I'll just disappear, and no one will find me.
I think there's about 30 cameras in there, there's a whole building. So once you go through the turnstile, you have to get through another sealed door and then to get into the security camera, the camera suite. And then if we then go onto the first floor, there's cameras every 10, 15 foot in this gap.
In my head, I was thinking, I'm going to prison, or I'm going to die. Yeah? Or they're going to kill me. So I'm thinking, what options have I got? Go to prison, get killed, kill my family.